Hello everyone, this is your host Sharmila and welcome back to my channel Sharmila's Kitchen. Today I'll be making marble cake. It is a wonderfully moist cake and made with swirls of vanilla and chocolate cake. You can also cover it with any frosting of your choice. Just look at the marble cake. It is so soft, moist and spongy. So let me show you the ingredients. To measure the quantities of the ingredients, today I am not going to be using any fancy measuring cup or spoons. Rather, I am going to be using our regular teacup and spoons to measure the quantities. Using my regular teacup, here I have taken 1.5 cup of refined flour or maida. In this cup, we have exactly 1 cup. I'll be using more half cup refined flour later in the batter. Using the same cup, here I have 3/4 cup eggs, which is equivalent to 3 large eggs. Then sugar 1 cup. Instead of butter, I'm gonna be using oil because oil adds more moisture to the marble cake. Then we need 1/4 teaspoon salt, few drops of vanilla essence, 1 teaspoon cocoa powder, baking powder 1/2 teaspoon, and buttermilk 3/4 cup. Now I'm going to be making the buttermilk first. Here I have taken lukewarm milk. In this milk, I'm gonna squeeze 1/2 of the lime. Just stir it, keep it aside for 10 minutes. After 10 minutes, you will able to see the milk is curdled, and this is called buttermilk what we need. Make sure all the ingredients are kept at room temperature. Next, line a baking tin with baking paper. Let's make the cake batter. In a mixing bowl, add vegetable oil and sugar, little bit of salt too. Now whisk it until they become nice and fluffy. If you have electric beater, you can also use it. After beating for 4 to 5 minutes, the mixture will become thick. Now add 1 egg at a time and mix with the batter. Make sure that you beat the egg well after each addition of egg until creamy. Now put a sieve onto the mixing bowl. In that, add the refined flour and sieve 1/2 of it. Next, add prepared buttermilk. Add 2 tablespoons of buttermilk. Next of the buttermilk and refined flour we'll be adding later. Now mix it in cut and fold method. First scrape around and cut in the middle. Now sieve rest of the refined flour and baking powder and also the rest of the buttermilk. Now mix it similarly in cut and fold method. Make sure the ingredients are well incorporated. Scrape down the sides when it needs. After mixing, the mixture will be light and fluffy. Now take out some of the batter in another bowl. And sieve the cocoa powder in the batter. Sieving the ingredients is very important to remove dirt and lumps. Now mix the cocoa powder in the batter and our chocolate batter is ready. Now in prepared baking tin, first add vanilla cake batter, about 2 big spoons. You should pour the vanilla cake batter little much than chocolate batter. Next, add chocolate batter in the center of the vanilla cake batter, only 1 tablespoon. Then add the vanilla cake batter in the center of the chocolate batter, then again chocolate batter. This way alternate spoonfuls of chocolate and vanilla cake batter until the batter is completed. Also make sure pour the cake batter in the center of the baking pan so that it can equally distributed in both sides. This way alternate spoonfuls of vanilla and chocolate batter until the last batter goes into the cake. Make sure that you don't overfill the baking pan because after baking the cake will rise double. Now let's make the marble effect on the cake batter. Using a knife or butter knife, first create wave pattern and in the middle of the wave create a straight line. Make sure you don't overmix the batter, otherwise the marble effect won't be visible. Now tap the cake batter to release the extra air bubbles. Now bake this cake for 20 to 25 minutes at 180 degrees centigrade until the cake is completely baked. After baking, cool down completely and take out of the baking pan. Now as you can see, my cake is completely baked and I am going to take out of the baking pan. First loosen the sides using a knife so that the cake can easily come out. Then invert the pan. The cake will easily come out of the pan. Then invert the baking pan. Because of the parchment sheet, the cake does not stick to the baking pan. And now pull off the baking paper. As you can see, the cake is completely done. The cake is not wet from any side. Now slice it and is ready to be served. You can have it immediately or store it for 3 to 4 days at room temperature. Look at the marble cake. It got nice marble pattern, soft and spongy. Thank you so much for joining me and my channel. I wish you're gonna give it a try very soon. If you like this recipe, please hit the like button, share with your family and friends, and don't forget to subscribe to my channel. I'll see you soon. Till then, take care.